Alright, so it's been a while since I played this. Close to a month, it looks like. I need a break, and now I'm back. So I'm gonna start Chapter 5. I probably won't play super long today because it's already kinda late, but we'll see what we can do. Maybe. Hello, game. Oh, there it goes. Okay.
Mid-August. It was the peak of summer, and the sweltering sun was beating down on the residents of Trista. After returning from Heimdall, we were given a whopping 5-day summer vacation before the school year resumed.
My game looks weird. I have a feeling something's screwed up. I might have to mess with some settings.
Turns out, Thor sticks to its military roots, only granting extended vacations to students over the New Year's holiday. However, nobles are allowed to visit home, ostensibly to give them time to become familiar with their family's holdings. And, as you might expect, that meant most students from classes 1 and 2 spent summer away from Trista. Meanwhile, classes 3 through 5 were stuck on campus, envying the nobility as they studied and trained as usual. The other members of class 7 and I chose to stay in Trista as well, facing the heat with our fellow students.
Could be my imagination, I don't know. We'll look at the settings in a second. Maybe it's fine. Yeah, okay, it's fine. It's just, I forgot there's like weird letterboxing in the cutscenes. Thank you. The face of someone you can trust.
Excuse me. I'll have you know I did no such thing. Today.
Mm-hmm.
Instructor?
Good morning, instructor.
Morning, everyone! Anyway, I'll have you know I've got a good reason for being late today.
You better.
And that reason is... we're going to be welcoming a new classmate today.
What?
Look at that conveniently empty seat over there.
A transfer student? At this time of year?
Seriously?
All right. Come on in.
Righto.
Huh?
Crow?
But isn't he a second year student?
I'm Crow Armbrust. Starting today, I'll be joining you fine folks as a member of Class 7. It's gonna be pretty sweet, guys.
What?
What?
What? I mean, how?
Are you sure you want to know? It's a long tale fraught with the intrigue of school politics.
I don't think I'd put it quite like that. In his first year, he slacked off so much that he ended up failing a few of his classes. Then he came crying to me in a panic, like, oh, help me, Instructor Sarah, they're not gonna let me graduate. So as a special exception, he's going to be joining us for the next 3 months to pay for his laziness.
You can't be serious.
That's an even more pathetic reason than I was bracing myself for.
I think you already know that Crow was one of the trial users for the Arcus test they ran last year. So I thought he might be a good role model for you. In that sense, anyway. And don't forget, he'll also be joining us on our future field studies, too.
Oh, boy.
Nice. Looks like you saved me the trouble of having to explain it all. Anyway, let's let the good times roll. Oh, and since we're all classmates now, no need for all that sweet talking you lay on the other second years, all right?
Right.
Easier said than done, I fear.
If he was any more laid back, he'd be comatose.
Instructor, I can't help but notice you left the door open.
Wait, is there someone else too?
Huh? Are you serious?
Aw, I was hoping to catch you off guard. All right. Come on in and say hello.
I thought you forgot I was out in the hall!
It's her.
What?
What?
You must be joking.
Hey, aren't you...
You're the girl we met in the Nord Highlands.
Yuppers! Long time no see, guys. But I see a couple of you I don't know, so I guess I better introduce myself. I'm Milliam. Milliam Orion.
That hat, though.
And this here is Eric Getlam. But we'll just call him Lammy for short.
What the hell is that? Holy crap!
It's that thing we saw at Ark's Fort.
So this is that strange girl you met in the Nord Highlands.
Oh, and a little house rule before anything gets blown up. No bringing that thing out in the classroom. If he accidentally smashes a wall or blasts through the ceiling, I'm the one who's gonna get chewed out for it.
Boo! Fine. Anyway! Nice to meet you guys!
I feel like we're short on desks.
Tell me you're kidding. Please?
I really wish I could.
Well, I can see we're in for some fun times these next 3 months.
Ugh. I wonder if they show up in my link log now. Crow's hard at work back there. No secrets there. him a stocking fee like usual, I guess.
As such, I'm planning on granting you a bit of additional assistance. I should have it ready for you in a few weeks' time.
Surprise us and be in our dorm suddenly. Alright, so... Oh, I wanted to check. They don't show up yet, I guess. Great. That's not bad though. I'm supposed to do, I think. Ring, ring.
Hello, Reen Schwarzer speaking.
Toa.
Do you have a moment?
Toa? Well, this is a surprise. What can I do for you?
You've got a new student in your class now, right? Well, her student notebook is ready, so I figured it'd be best to get it to her as soon as possible. And since you handled it last time, would you mind coming to get it for her?
Ah, you're talking about Milliam. Sure thing. I'll come get it right away. You want me to swing by the student council room then?
That'd be great.
She sure doesn't waste any time. I should head on over to the student council room before it gets too late.
Oh, I got time. Don't even worry about it. Thank you. So let's see what this new thing does. Not bad. That's actually not bad at all. Lots of defense, lots of HP. Might try to find someone to throw that on. Downstairs now. I might swing by these other doors first. Still don't. You still just paint white paint on a white canvas. Cool. the infirmary up next. I believe I have another medal to pick up there. Other items are. Ooh, that's a good mage one. That one's not bad either. School. Probably. Thank you. think that was the new one. Yeah. Cat. How am I doing on milk right now anyways? I don't even know. I have a lot of it. I'm good. Alright. I need something from you. Thank you. Okay. Building now. Imperial Chronicle, let's find out. Westemeria trade conference thing happens in the Crossbell games. Or if it's just maybe slightly mentioned. Seems to be a noble. I'm surprised he's still around. Walking wasn't so clunky. Hmm. There he is. But it seemed like a good purchase. It has some good stuff on it. Throw it on one of my mage characters. Let's see.
Right.
Okay, so let's go find Toa, who should be over here. Oh, we'll do that in a second. We have people to talk to.
If I disturbed you.
Oh, Rain! Not at all. Sorry for making you come all the way out here.
Don't worry about it. It's class business anyway. That's quite the spread you've got on your desk there. Is it just me, or does your workload only ever seem to increase?
Notebook. Crow's already got one, along with the added pages on the Arcus units you all have. So she's the last one to meet.
All right. I'll be sure to pass this on to Million next time I see her. Actually, if you don't mind my asking, how much do you know about why she's here at the Academy?
All I know is that she came with a recommendation from the Army's Intelligence Division, really. You know those combat shells you fight in your practical exams? They're being used with the Emperor's authorization. Apparently, it's something similar for Millium. They can't deny her admission if the Emperor's pushing it through.
This goes all the way up to His Majesty?
Seems like it. The Chancellor was the one who set up both the Intelligence Division and the Railway Military Force. But neither of those organizations could have been established without His Majesty's consent. That's what's unusual. Anyway, because of that, the Academy can't really turn down a direct referral with that kind of backing.
So that's how it is. But even accounting for that, I never would have expected Crow to be transferred into our class, too.
Yeah. I was just as shocked as you when I found out. I knew he was a habitual class cutter, but I always figured he at least had enough credits to graduate. Oh, I feel like a failure as student council president for not noticing. Maybe even a failure as a friend.
Whoa there. I think you're being a little hard on yourself. What about Angelica? Does she have enough credits to graduate?
Angie at least makes sure to attend the classes she needs for graduation. Apparently, Crow not only hadn't attended enough class units, he also didn't turn in some essential assignments. But as long as he's active and engaged with his Class 7 work over the next couple months, he'll be able to graduate.
Not convenient.
Still, I get the distinct feeling this 1-2 punch of transfer students wasn't just a happy coincidence. Am I right?
Well, yeah. The principal thought placing Crow in Class 7 might be beneficial for the rest of you, too. His grades might be a sorry sight, but he really knows how to get things done when he wants to. Did you know he was responsible for all of the event planning at last year's Academy Festival?
Crow did that? Voluntarily?
It might be kind of awkward having a second-year student in your class, but I hope you guys will all get along. That goes for Milliam too, of course. She might have an unusual background, but at the end of the day, she's still a 13-year-old girl.
Yeah, I get what you mean. So she really is 13 then?
Yeah, she scored really well on her entrance exam though, so I think she can handle the curriculum fine. She might be small, but she can roll up her sleeves with the best of them.
Now where have I heard of someone like that before? Oh, sorry. Looks like I've got a call coming in.
Go ahead and answer. I don't mind. I wouldn't want you to miss anything important.
All right. Excuse me then. Hello? Reen Schwarzer speaking.
Hello, Reen. It's your favorite instructor here.
Who?
Are you still on the Academy grounds by any chance?
As much as it pains me to say it, I am.
No need to sound so suspicious. It's just that after I gave Milliam all the things I had for her, she just took off somewhere. You know how she tends to be kind of a mischief maker. So could you find her and drag her back to the dorms for me?
All right. I can only imagine what would happen if she were to flash that silver thing of hers around on the Academy grounds again.
Yeah, I'd really rather avoid a repeat of yesterday. Anyway, I leave it in your capable hands, brave leader of Class 7.
Wait a second. When did I become the...
She really does trust you. Anyway, I'll let you go then. Are you still up for helping me with a few requests tomorrow?
Of course. I'll be around. Still, I know you've got a full slate and all, but try not to overwork yourself. And if there's anything else I can do to make life a little easier for you, don't hesitate to ask.
Sure. And thanks.
Those two will work. Building first, I guess. There she is. Thank you. Huh. Should like that too much. Alright. Now it looks like she's at the gymnasium, so let's head over there. That's everything for this area, I guess. The hunting club is open right now, let's check them out. Fair enough. Let's go this way. Looks like we're heading over here next. See if they have anything new to say. to the main school building now. Hooray. So
wowee, there's so much cool stuff here.
Kind of reminds me of the redhead dude. I forgot his name. The like right hand man of someone. Was it Osborne? I think Osborne, maybe. I don't know. One that showed up in third.
So this is Thor's military academy, huh? I think I'm gonna like it here. Ooh, I wonder what the view from the rooftop's like. Huh? Hmm.
Does she have Vocaloid now? That's the name.
Hey guys, welcome back.
And Crow's here now.
Welcome back, everyone.
Just been making myself at home here.
Crow?
What are you doing in our dormitory?
Well, I am a member of Class 7 now, so I've been given the go-ahead to move into this dorm now.
What?
Don't you think it's a bit sudden?
But man, Sharon sure makes some amazing coffee. If I'd had a cup of that, I would have been banging down the door to join Class 7 months ago.
You flatter me, Master Crow. Would you like me to bring some of the cakes I baked earlier as well?
Do you even need to ask? Anyway, sorry it kind of came out of nowhere, but it's good to be here.
Looks like he's already made himself at home.
Sharon didn't seem to miss a beat either. So you're gonna be living here too, huh?
Yep. Us newcomers have to stick together, right? I just finished hauling all my stuff over from my old dorm. Looks like I ended up in the room right across from yours, Reen.
I see. I can already see things getting a lot more lively around here.
Oh boy.
Ooh, man. Moving all those things really tired me out. I was hoping I could just stow all my junk in my old room, but Toa wouldn't let me.
Well, of course she wouldn't.
You must be pretty exhausted. Well, I suppose now's as good a time as any to officially welcome you to the Class 7 dormitory.
The pleasure's mine. And seriously, you don't have to make a big deal out of it. Come on, loosen up a little. We're classmates now. Just treat me like one of the gang and we're golden.
You sure about that? All right, one of the gang it is. Feels weird to think of you that way after all this time, though.
It's not like we're trying to make a big deal out of it. It's just still kind of weird having you as a classmate, that's all.
Don't worry. I'm sure we'll be shooting the breeze like old buddies in no time. Oh, and if you guys don't mind, I want to get in on the action when you explore the old schoolhouse tomorrow. Gotta get back in the groove with my Arcus again, after all.
Huh? A schoolhouse?
Oh boy, Millie and Min Crow are probably gonna have to come along, huh?
Who'd want to go to school on their day off?
Well, we've got this, this special schoolhouse here.
Whoa, really? That sounds kind of cool. I want to come too.
How did I know you were going to say that?
Gives me an opportunity to kind of remember what they specialize in, at least.
Didn't I just get done telling you how dangerous it is?
Oh, you don't have to worry about me. As long as I've got Lammy, it'll be easy peasy. And if you didn't take me with you, I'd just break down the door and come after you.
I wouldn't really put it past her either.
All right. Have it your way. I'll be sure to let you and Crow know when I'm planning on heading into the old schoolhouse tomorrow. But don't just go wandering in there on your own without us, all right?
Yes, sir! Oh, I can't wait to see what it's like down there! So exciting! I might not even be able to sleep tonight!
It's a labyrinth full of monsters here, not a theme park.
Looks like I better give my pistols a little TLC tonight.
Be so fun going into that prologue stuff again. See if I can go talk to Beeps real quick. Crow, what's up? I see your sexy model back there. Myself a casino going on in here. Let's see. I'm assuming that means Elliot's probably not going to be available for the schoolhouse. Machias too, from that looks of that. That's okay, I'm probably gonna bring Elisa with me as my fourth. head back upstairs. It's Millium's room. All our stuffed animals, apparently. Super service day? I can't tell. Is that supposed to be a palm? I might not be available either then. Might have to bring Emma along. This one, let's see. What's it do? Tax craft cost, status down. That's not a bad one, actually. He has Demonic Scythe, which is also a decent skill. His strength is 666. I don't know how I feel about you, Crow. 215. It's not a great caster, okay. Meanwhile... she isn't either, really, I guess. What's Aegis do? Yes. It's not a bad one. It's very defensive. That's not a bad one at all. Alright. Oh, they're on my stuff now. Let's see. That's pretty cool. And what'd she do? Fair enough. Okay. And I think I'm gonna call it here, even though we haven't done too much action today, but I didn't really want to play too long, because it got late before I even started. But I will try to get back to this game more often than like once a month. I don't know how busy I'm gonna be this week, so we'll see. But I'll try to get into it again later this week. Anyway, I'll catch you guys later.